In this tutorial, I'm going to take you through the whole process of creating a Python virtual environment on the Mac operating system. The macOS comes shipped with Python already installed. It isn't the latest version, but it is a version of Python. We need to be careful about that. So just go ahead and press go to go, and then select utilities. And then from here, just open up the terminal. And from here, we can type in Python dash dash version. And that would tell us that we have Python 2.7.18 as of recorded in this tutorial installed already. So first up, we're going to install homebrew. So this is a piece of software which essentially allows us to install packages from the command line. We're going to use this to install Python. So go ahead and type this in. Now I have left this command in the video description. So there is no space here between this dot and git here. So if you are typing this in, just type this whole thing in and then press enter. And that should then take you through the process of then installing. So press return to continue. So that's probably going to take a couple of seconds to install. So give that a couple of seconds and I'll see you in a second. Okay, so once we've finished installing Homebrew, and that might have taken a couple of minutes in actual fact there, we're told here the next steps are to run two commands. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm just going to copy that in, run the first command, and then we're told to then run the second command. Run the two commands, profile, and then the second command here. And there we go. So let's go ahead now and type in brew help just to see if this is working okay. Looks like it is. So I think we're ready to get going and installing Python. Okay, so now we're ready to start thinking about installing Python. So what we can use here is a piece of software called asdf. And this tool, let's go have a little look at this tool, asdf. This tool is going to allow us to manage our Python installations. So it's a version manager here. So this is what we're going to install, and that's going to help us then or support the process of installing and managing Python installed on your machine. So the command here is pretty simple. We're going to use brew to install this. So brew install asdf and then open SSL readline SQLite. So that's ITE, sorry, 3, xzzlib. So give that an install. Probably take a couple of seconds to install. So now we need to make sure that ASDF is loaded for both the current and future shell sessions. So again, another long-winded command. I'm going to press Command and K to clear. So here we're using the Z shell. It says right here Z shell. So we're going to need the following command. So I'm just going to copy and paste this in. You'll find this in the video description. So give that a go and press Enter. And now we can go ahead and we can now say ASDF plugin and then add Python. Okay, so now we're ready to install Python. So asdf and then install Python. And this is where we can choose what version of Python we want to install. Now, the important thing here is, off the top of my head, if memory serves me right, the latest version of Python, that's going to cause you issues when creating a virtual machine. So we definitely don't want to install, if my memory serves me right, the latest version as of recording this, which is around about Python 3.10. So we'll go safe and we'll install Python 3.9. So I'm keeping this safe. Let's go ahead and asdf install Python 3.9.2. So that's going to take a couple minutes to download. Once that's done, we'll move on. So once that's installed, we can now say asdf and make this version global. So we can say Python, the version we stored was 3.9.2. So that's going to make this the global version of Python on this machine. So I press enter, and now I need to close this and then go back into it for it to work. So let's just open this up again. So now when I type in python-version, it now shows me 3.9.2, the version we just installed. So let's make sure we've got the latest version of pip, the Python package manager. So we're going to say pip install pip setup tools. So that just makes sure everything is up to date with the package tools there. Okay, so now we can install virtual environments. So Python using the m flag, pip install virtual env. Okay, so that's the virtual environment kind of setup. So now we can create some virtual environments. So before we do that, we just need to kind of refresh everything. So let's type in asdf reshim Python. So give that a go. And now when I type in virtual env, you can see that we've got some options here. It tells me how to utilize it. So I've created an empty folder here on my desktop called project. What I need to do is I need to go into that. So I type in cd to change directory. If I just drag this in and press enter, it then takes me to that folder. So I'm now working with inside of this folder here. So I can now type in virtual env, and then the name of the folder I want to create a virtual environment within. And a couple of seconds later, if I now go into the project folder, you should see a new folder called virtual environment. So that's my virtual environment. Now it's going to take a couple of seconds for everything to kind of load up. But once that's done, let me just clear that. I can now activate the virtual environment. I need to be in the actual project folder here. So what I need to say is source, and then the folder is called venv. Inside of there, there's a folder called bin, and inside of there is an activation tool. So I can now activate the virtual environment, and you can now see I've activated my virtual environment. So if you wanted to deactivate this, you could just close the window, and there we go. So let me just show you how that works with Visual Studio Code. So go ahead and type in Visual Studio Code in the browser. Go ahead and download the version of Video Studio Code that you need, whether it's Silicon Chip or whether you're using an older Mac. And then once that's downloaded, you literally just need to click on it, and that will open up Visual Studio Code. So once Visual Studio Code is open, just go ahead and file, open a new folder. I've made a new folder on the desktop again. File, open folder, and then I'll just go into the folder. Yep, so I made a folder called project, so I'm going to open that. And now what I can do is I can lift this up here, just drag and lift this up, or I can press control and the button above it. That will just open and close this on a Mac. So control button and the button above it, the title button key. So from here I can now make, in my new project, I can make a virtual environment. So I can say virtual env venv. That creates a virtual environment, as you've seen before. And now I can go ahead and just activate that. So source venv and then bin activate. And there we go. So now I can go ahead and pip install any packages that I need to run the Python application, or any dependencies that my Python package needs through pip. Okay, and there we have it. So that's how to get the virtual environment sorted, set up on the Mac. There are different versions of this installation guide that you'll see around. This is probably one of the better ways of doing it, in my opinion, because you have a little bit more control. If I wanted to upgrade Python, for example, I could do through ASDF and just activate that as my main Python tool on my machine. And then I can also downgrade. So if I'm working with a project that requires Python 3.8, then I can easily use ASDF to install Python 3.8 and then just activate it as the main version of Python I want to work with. And then you can hopefully see how versatile that is and easy to work with once it's set up. Now that's a massive difference if you've come from a Windows environment, which only takes like a couple of seconds to set up. There's quite a few steps there to take, but ultimately, hopefully that was useful, and I hope to see you in another tutorial. If you do have any problems, just to make a note there, if you do have any problems or issues, then please let me know in the comments and I'll try and help you out. This is a process which can take a very long time for new developers to go through and can put off some people from developing in Python because they can't get these tools sorted. So yeah, any problems, any issues, let me know in the comments, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.